Today, I'm going to make three dishes that, trust me, they're going to be very, very interesting and delicious. My recipes, I make sure they're very simple, the ingredients are easy to find, and even an amateur cook can prepare this, okay? My very first recipe is a dish called Fiesta Fish. These are the festive ingredients for Fiesta Fish. 1 kilo or more of white fish, that could be sole, lapu-lapu, halibut, what have you, no? You have mayonnaise, pickle relish, chopped boiled eggs with the whites and yolks separated. We also have chopped white onions here, some finely chopped pimiento drained, chopped carrots, finely chopped broccoli, sliced ginger, and spring onions cut into 4-inch slices. So this one, I'm going to use sole. So it's a fillet, white fillet of fish. So itong sole, this is kind of thin, eh, no? So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use 2 fillets. So, inalapu-lapu kasi top and bottom. And then there's this, yung bones in the middle. So, this is boneless. Now, I have here ginger and spring onions. Look. So, I'll lay this on a plate like this. And then we're going to steam this, okay? Ginger and spring onions. And then these are the fish fillets, okay? Yung sole, okay? And then what you want to do is just lay this fish fillet over the ginger and spring onion, okay? Then we will get more ginger and spring onion. Lay it again. Yan. So these are mga 3 or 4 inch spring onions, okay? And then put this over again. Okay. And you know what I have? I have an improvised steamer. Okay? So I put it in a plate like this. I'll top it with more ginger and spring onions just to get the aroma. Anyway, this is going to be flavored with different kinds of toppings. Eh, no? So like this, yung ginger and spring onion, we will remove this later. Okay? Just put it like this. Yeah. Then put it on top. Yo. And then cover this. And this we will steam. This is an improvised steamer. We will steam this for about 20-30 minutes. Okay? We will come back to this one the moment this is done. This one is done. Yan. You know what I was thinking of doing? Yung, kasi what I'm going to do is layer it with mayonnaise, some vegetables. What I want to do here is get some of this juice, diba? May tasty tong juice na ito eh. Okay, and mix it with the mayonnaise because it has a little flavor from the ginger, the spring onion, salt, pepper. Okay, and this one is done. Okay, we will just set this aside. Okay, set it aside lang and then I'll show you how to assemble this, okay? Let's remove the ginger and spring onions because we just needed this to flavor it. Yum! Well, I got 2 fillet of soles, okay? And I'm going to layer them here. Make sure walang ginger kasi medyo turn off ang ginger eh. Okay? So let's remove the ginger. Okay? And then, lay it here. And just wait for it to chill a little bit. And then we will assemble this. We will put the other ingredients or the toppings the moment it stops steaming. But you know what? I want to keep this mga spring onions and top it with this also because this will give it an extra flavor. Okay, what I'm doing, you know what? This was ano eh, yung spur of the moment lang. I saw the mayonnaise and then I saw the some of the juices from the fish and sabi ko sayang. You know, you use your imagination and be creative. So what I did was I poured some of the flavored fish juice flavored with spring onions and ginger and the fish and I mixed it with the mayonnaise, diba? Now, this is what we will do. You know, the reason I don't want to mix or put the mayonnaise topping is because of the heat, it will break. Remember, it's like we're making a fish salad, okay? we can actually start it. Okay, now, let's put the mayonnaise last. Okay, let's start with broccoli. Okay, broccoli. Okay. Then we will put in our egg white muna. Yung hard-cooked egg whites. Okay. I'm gonna put a lot of, so make sure your hands are clean, okay? Now, let's get our carrots. So these are raw carrots also. If you want to use a whole yung salmon fillet, go ahead and do that. Okay. So the contrasts are colors na pinag-usapan. The taste is going to be there, trust me. The taste is going to be very good. Now, we are going to go with pickle relish naman. Okay? So we're going to add a little sweetness to this mixture. Pickle relish. You know, you have to balance it also. I don't recommend you use red onions because the flavors are gonna be too strong, okay? So we don't want that. Egg yolk. This is hard egg yolk. Okay. The one that most of us are used to, yung the way it's displayed, is it's mayonnaise, pickle relish, carrots, what have you. I don't like that because what will happen is that you have to get from the bottom this way. This way, you can get slices and just mix it, diba? Now, we have white onions. Okay? And then, what we will do, okay? I was supposed to put the mayonnaise here at the bottom, but what I'll do is I'll just put our pimiento here. Okay? And use your imagination. Imagine, where do you think I'll put the mayonnaise? Ah, diba? Yan, look at this. Look at that. Ganda, diba? Nice, diba? Now, mayonnaise. Okay. Maybe I can use a bigger plate next time. I'm just going to put the mayonnaise around. What do you think? Diba? Yo. Okay, yan. And then, the other side naman. Okay. Look at that. So we're just trying to fix up the appearance, but the taste is going to be very good. So what you want to do, get a plate and get it this way and then just mix. Fish salad. This one is called Fiesta Fish. It's so simple to make and it is delicious. I will show you the joy of constructing this deconstructed sushi dish. Next on Casa Daza. You know, when this pandemic happened, a lot of people started cooking, diba, at home. And in the process of that, a lot of people realized they had talent in the kitchen. And there were some very popular items. For example, ube pandesal. I started making my own version of yung kimchi fried rice. And then there was one that was sent to me a lot. It was sushi bake. Now, there were a few that were very, very good. Some parang, okay lang. You know, the moment you've tried the really good ones, it's the other ones that come along, parang, yeah, they're good, but they're not great. One of the best ones that I tried, no, in fact, the best one that I tried, and it was a sushi bake with unagi on top. Oh my gosh, because when I tried that, you know, I said, why don't I create my own sushi bake? Anybody can make this, you know? You know, the ingredients are so easy to find now. You go to many Korean stores or Japanese stores, you'll find the ingredients. Okay, so let me show you how to assemble my version of sushi bake. Here are the ingredients that you will need to make my sushi bake, and it's all very simple. Cooked rice, sushi vinegar, nori flakes, flaked crab sticks, finely chopped cooked shrimp, and chopped squid meat that's already cooked as well. Then, there are chopped onions, chopped hard-boiled eggs, sriracha, Japanese mayo, wasabi, tobiko, chopped boneless chicken teriyaki. We have some cooked rice. If you want to use Japanese rice, fine, do that, no? I've even learned how to make my own, ano? Yung sushi, I have the sushi, you know? Yung sushi mat, I have sushi vinegar. So many people didn't know that you have to use this on chilled rice when you make sushi. Okay, so mix this together very, very well. Okay, now, okay, I have my sushi plate here. Okay, put the rice here. Actually, you know, my kids love this. When every time somebody sends me, ooh, sarap. So we will just flatten this like this. So you go like this, flatten it lang. Okay, now we are going to put the topping of this ano, of this rice. Japanese mayo, very, very important, okay? There's a totally different taste to this Japanese mayo. And then I'm going to put a little wasabi. Just a little. Siguro mga half a teaspoon. Para may kalabit lang siya ng wasabi. Then, I'm going to put some chopped hard-cooked eggs. Okay. Sriracha. Yan. Okay. We have some onions. Okay. Red onions naman to. These are strong. Okay. And then, I have boiled squid. Siguro mga boil for about 2 minutes and then I chop it. Okay? And then I have yung fake crab. Okay? Shrimps. Boiled shrimps, which I chopped also. Okay? Then I'm going to mix this. Okay? With the mayonnaise. One of the staple dishes of Japan are unagi or chicken teriyaki. So what I've done is I cooked a chicken teriyaki on the side. I just fried it and then chopped it up. I'm going to top this later, okay? So let's just mix this very, very well. So what I'm going to do is I have some nori flakes also. Oh, these are mixtures of different sesame seeds, nori flakes, what have you. And then I'm going to put this on top of the rice. Okay, look at that. And then I'm going to put this on top. This is my version, ah. Okay. I just picked up ideas from the different sushi bakes that I've tried. Okay. And you spread it all over. So, mine, it's loaded with seafood. I'm going to add some flakes later. So, what I'm going to do at this point, okay, some Japanese mayo. Okay. Just put like this. Lang. Okay, not too much kasi I find it too rich. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to bake this in the oven. Siguro mga 300 degrees for about 5 minutes lang. What I want to do here is that the oil of the mayonnaise will melt and drip into the rice and flavor it. Okay, I'll come back to this one. What I want you to do is chill it a little bit, and then what we will do is just top it. These are tobiko flakes, no? You can find these in many Korean stores. Okay, these are fish eggs. Okay. Sarap yan. Yan. Spread it all over. Look at that. Now, at this point, we want to add color. So these are nori flakes, flavored nori flakes. You know, I put in ato. These are chicken teriyaki. Ooh. Chicken teriyaki. Make sure your hands are clean, of course, diba? The chicken teriyaki is just a mixture of soy sauce and sugar, ginger, and mirin wine. You marinate the boneless chicken thigh and then you just fry it. Okay, and that's it. So this is my sushi bake. It's very simple to make, and trust me, you will love this. So, I have one more dish with ingredients that look like a mishmash mix. But I'm telling you that my Asian meatloaf dish is going to be delicious. Stay tuned for that recipe, only here at Casa Daza. This dish I picked up from the traditional American meatloaf. Pero what I did was instead of using their flavorings, I used Asian ingredients. This one is called Asian meatloaf. Here are the ingredients that you will need: 1/2 kilo of ground pork, 1/2 kilo of ground beef, breadcrumbs, and chopped onions. Some finely chopped Chinese chorizo, salt, banana ketchup, oyster sauce, hoisin sauce, sesame oil, and chili garlic. And we will also include 2 eggs. Okay, I'm gonna show you how to assemble it. Me, when I mix the sauces or this whole mixture, I like to mix the sauces first. Kasi what some people do is they get their ground meats and then they put the sauces on top and then they mix it. Me, what I like to do is I mix all the sauces together, like what I'll do, I'll show you, so that one taste na siya. This is our hoisin sauce, sesame oil. We have chili garlic sauce. Okay, a chili garlic sauce. We have some oyster sauce. Okay. Now, instead of using tomato ketchup, I'm using banana ketchup. Oh, diba? And then some salt. Chinese chorizo. And then, these are chopped Chinese chorizo. Onions, okay? Red onions. There's a difference between the red and the white onions. Huh? The red onions are very strong in flavor. Okay? And then what I will do here is mix all of these ingredients very well. Make sure that your hands are clean, huh, before you, because I'm going to dig in. A lot of people say, oh, they're going to use their fork and spoon. I'm going to use my hands because you can feel it. Okay, ito na. Ground beef, ground pork, breadcrumbs. You know what the breadcrumbs does? I always say this. What the breadcrumbs does is that when you bite it or slice into a meatloaf, you'll notice it's not that oily because the breadcrumbs absorb the oil and then, but all the flavors are there, okay? So what you want to do then is add 1 or 2 whole eggs. Okay, and then mix. You know, here you have to be very patient. Make sure that you mix it very, very well. So I start from the side of the bowl and then lift it and bring it towards the middle. So just relax, take your time. No one's rushing you. Okay. So the eggs are going to be used as a binder and you can feel the lumps also. Make sure there are no lumps. What you want to do is spread the flavors of the sauces so that when you bite into the meatloaf, you know, all the blended flavors will come out. Okay, what I want to do then is I'm going to bake this at 350 degrees for about an hour. You know, you can also use your imagination. You want to put bacon all over? Why not, diba? This is very good. You know, my friend keeps on telling me, why do you keep on saying, trust me? Because you have to trust me with the recipes I give you. I try and test all my recipes. So I make sure they're easy to make, ingredients are easy to find. You're going to love cooking. Let me bring this to the oven. Here we have it. I've plated the meatloaf. This is the Asian meatloaf. You know, there is a lot of oil that comes out from the drippings of the meatloaf. You can use that and mix it with rice. That's going to be a very flavorful rice. Okay, so let me show you. I will just slice a piece. This is so good. So, so good. Look at that. Look at that, though. It looks like it's not as oily. Why? Because of the presence of the breadcrumbs. See? Look at that. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. So there you have it. This one is called Asian meatloaf. It is so good. It's like a complete dish. It's simple, it's easy to make, and it is so, so good. Today, we made three dishes. One is a fiesta fish. You know, I just thought about this. Because this one relies on the mayonnaise to give it the flavoring. You may use Japanese mayonnaise. Why not, diba? Anyway, you're making the sushi bake. Okay, so it's actually a fish salad. Now, I also made a Asian meatloaf. This is so good. It's so, so good. The drippings from the meatloaf, you can make that and mix that with the rice. So may fried rice ka. Just loaded with flavor. Now this one is my version of sushi bake, okay? The way they do this, okay, is you get one small piece like this. I'm not gonna put the topping first, okay? And then you get one nori sheet. Go like this. Mmm! Winner. Ang sarap. Now, you wanna put unagi also, go ahead and do that. What I'm going to do is I'll put a slice of chicken teriyaki. You know, you can make this easily at home. Mm. See? It's like a complete dish. It's simple, it's easy to make, and it is so, so good. I'll see you again next time on Casa Dazzle.